emergency situation has been confirmed in this area. You are requested to leave the building. Use the stairways and marked exits only. Do not use the elevators. Do not use the elevators. Move quickly and quietly. Do not run. Do not run.
There are many reasons why a building or a group of buildings may need to be evacuated, including fires, chemical spills, toxic or explosive gas releases, explosions, violent behavior, and bomb threats. The larger the building, the more organization is required to ensure everyone is evacuated effectively and as safely as possible. But regardless of the size or type of building or buildings, or number of employees, every organization should have a tried and tested evacuation plan, a plan that everyone must be familiar with. Everyone must know their role in the event of an evacuation, or if they are the first to notice an emergency. An evacuation plan is often developed by an emergency planning committee. The starting point of most plans, except for very small sites, would normally include a location that is to be used as the central evacuation control center, the location of various assembly points. These assembly points are used for people to gather to assist in an orderly evacuation, and the location of an external assembly area that is well clear of buildings. This is the area where everyone gathers after they leave the immediate area of potential danger. Many evacuation plans call for the installation and maintenance of an emergency communication system. Likewise, an audible warning system is often used. Clearly, it is important that everyone understands the meaning of any sounds produced by alarms.